Hi Taurus, welcome back to Omkara Tarot and to your last love bite for the month of March. Let's see what message there is for you today, Taurus. These are general collective readings, will not resonate with all of you. Take what works for you, okay? Leave the rest. So my angel spirit guides, please bless this reading for Taurus and send them the messages they need to hear the most right now. Thank you. So Taurus, let's begin with your reading. Let's see what message wants to show through for you. And welcome back, all my subscribers. Welcome in, newbies. If you enjoy the reading, do join us. Become part of our Omkara family. We welcome you in. And if any of you are looking for a private reading, Taurus, my email is in the description box below. You can reach me there. So the cards I have on the table right now. Oh my God. Bottom of my deck, I do see a tower moment coming. It's either just happened, is happening, or is about to happen. So just a little heads up, Taurus. Yes, there is a break in a love connection here, center of my spread. A soulmate connection gone wrong, and somebody wanting to release this toxic energy, feeling always left out, abandoned. And wanting to get out of feeling like this all the time, wanting to drop a burden. I don't think there's any communication between the two of you either. So let's see what's going on. Let's start with some dialogue message cards and see what this is all about. Taurus and their person spirit, if they could say something to each other, since I see there is no communication, barely any, if there is, what would they like to say to each other now? Taurus and their person spirit. And I'll take a couple more from here, Taurus. Good to go, Taurus. Let's begin our reading. The first card here says, "You knowingly brought me into a clusterfuck of a situation. I trusted you to do what was right, and you let me down." Well, this could be part of the tower moment. "I always look out for you because I love you unconditionally. I try to warn you about fake people with bad intentions who are out there to manipulate and use you. It cuts deep because you seem to trust everyone else over me." You go to bed with someone else and your soul comes to make love to me. I know when you're with someone else and this just makes me feel heartbroken. You should be making love to me. I tried to help you with your addictions, but you took my love for granted. I was happy and carefree before, but you kept taking from me. You stole my heart, you stole my love, my light, my well-being. I'm trying to recover from this and heal myself. This is definitely a connection gone wrong here, Taurus. Don't come back to me if you haven't leveled up. I knew all along that you had the potential to run again, but the intensity of our connection and my curiosity about it is what kept me interested in you. My boundaries are stronger now, and your old mind games will no longer be tolerated. Oof, this is like a love. Love and being loved is the most beautiful, crazy, unexpected, magical feeling I've ever felt. Thank you for loving me the way that you do. I love you to infinity. This could be somebody else. This doesn't seem like this character here. Walking away from you was the hardest thing I've ever done in my life, and it's my biggest regret. I don't expect you to be perfect. I love your perfect imperfections because they make my life as perfect as one can imagine. I know I hurt you. Please forgive me. I want to restore your faith in me. What I'm in most need of, you cannot give me. Oh my God, volatile situation here with the big tower that's erupted here. Maybe somebody got caught, or I'm stammering. This is crazy. Something kind of backfired here. Somebody could be dealing with a trickster here, and somebody is kind of thinking of leaving and going off for a fresh new beginning, leaving a very, very selfish person behind. So let's start clarifying these cards. If this is your situation, I hope it's not though, but whoever is in this situation, I'm going to take an angel blessing card to first bless this reading with a blessing, guidance, advice. Yes, this situation involves marriage. Maybe leaving an old partner behind. This is cutting cords as well in a marriage. This card sometimes symbolizes that. And this could be moving towards a new partnership, a new marriage. All right, Taurus, let's see. What's this Five of Pentacles spirit and the Eight of Wands? What's this Five of Pentacles and the Eight of Wands? Yeah, somebody doesn't want to be in a situation which always makes them feel bad, feeling isolated, always a lot of competition, always a lot of fighting, conflict, and saying, hey, I'm not even interested in talking to this person. It's better that it ends. This is like complete ending, complete ending. Somebody is wanting to lay down this burden now. I can't carry it anymore. Ten of Wands spirit, what's this Ten of Wands? Yes, somebody just wants this bad phase of their life to be over now. I think they've been in depression and sadness for too long. And yes, they feel their partner is a promise breaker. They haven't fulfilled any of their wishes. Whatever sweet words they come with, it always ends up to be empty promises. And somebody is ready now to let go of this situation and say it's over. Now the memories made in this connection are not the greatest. Six of Cups in reverse. And the Two of Cups in reverse. Yes, somebody doesn't want to be in this overthinking, not being able to sleep at night, crying, depression, and thinking it's better that instead of juggling and keeping this thing going, I just drop the ball here and release this toxicity from my life once and for all. Two of Cups, spirit. Yes, somebody wants to charge ahead with their own life, their own goals. And the Devil in reverse spirit? Yes, because they are realizing this toxicity is bringing too much imbalance into their life. This connection is not balanced from any angle. Somebody's gotten fed up, I think. Hermit in reverse? Hermit in reverse? Only reason I think they haven't yet made a move is because they don't want to make any foolish mistakes here or any unwise decisions. They don't want whatever move they're going to make to backfire on them, even though they know that they're dealing with somebody who's very immature and not really worth investing time in. They're still trying to gather their courage. Trying to get out of overthinking. Yes, look at this, my God. Trying so hard to cut these chains which are keeping them bound. Remove the blindfold from their eyes. Cut these chains. Remove these bondages that are keeping them in the past. And but still trying to, I think, gather some courage here to do this. What's the Strength card in reverse, spirit? Strength card in reverse. Yes, this is a long-term partnership, marriage, commitment, which is not working here, Taurus. Eight of Swords. Eight of Swords in reverse. Yeah, somebody's still at crossroads, still kind of being pulled between the past and the future, still trying to understand what is their next move now, but desperately wanting to remove these chains from them and move on. Contemplation mode, thinking about it, planning their next move. So, what's this tower, spirit? This bothers me. What's this tower? What's this tower? Tower is clarified by the tower in reverse. Yes, This tower will erupt. I have a feeling it will, but the dust will soon settle from what I feel. Somebody is letting go of somebody who was a liar, bad communicator, very cold person, not emotional at all. I don't think they are very happy with this. This Ten of Cups feeling is just not coming. And somebody is now, you know, going to surprise or shock their partner by saying, I'm going off for a brand new life. Brand new beginning for myself. So I hope this is not your reading, Taurus, but if it is, if it helps, I don't know. We'll check in a little deeper next time. Let me know if it resonated and I'll try my best, or you can maybe get a personal reading to solve this. Anyway, so take care of yourself. Love and light. Namaste.